college hockey world are on the TD Bank North Garden tonight as two of the top teams in the nation come across town to battle for the 57th Beanpot Championship.
Both squads.
And both teams have it in spades. They have, as we said, been two of the best in the nation. Here's a turnover right in front, and Teason makes his first save of the night. Call. Take a look at that last chance for Chris Higgins.
Yeah, right off the faceoff, take care of the puck. We just got through saying it almost on cue. Limit your turnovers in all three zones, and Higgins with the mishandle, able to take that puck to the back end. Power play, they're not getting anything on goal. They had two shots attempted that were blocked, one by Strait, one by Gilroy.
There's an opportunity in front, and Milan is called on to step up and stop Steve Silva, and he does just that.
Well, with the earlier power play unit, they try to work everything from the blue line. Here they're going to make a play down low, close quarters, a little backhand feed from the corner. Silva, that puck on edge, he just wants to get it in the direction at the top of the crease.
See the numbers, 45 saves in that first game, tying his career best. Higgins taking it down low. Cohen sliding it across. Takes it back from Shattenkirk. Scores! Power play goal! And Boston University is on the board first.
Well, the BU fans enjoying this 5-on-3. The good, hard, crisp passing, particularly out high. And Cohen is going to set up for the one-timer. Shattenkirk looking down low. You try to move that puck in a 5-on-3. Down low, out high, as quickly as you possibly can in order to get the defending team in their triangle formation have to move. When they move, there are more seams created. Not that there aren't enough already in a 5-on-3, but that overhead was...
Power play goal, Northeastern. Off the draw, trying to get something here in the final seconds. The pass in front, Vitali knocked down, rebound, score! McLaughlin buries it with 26 seconds remaining.
And there was going to be a penalty on the play to BU. Shattenkirk had an opportunity with his long reach when he corralled the puck off the faceoff to try and get it out of BU's end. Couldn't quite do it. Northeastern, with that determined effort, able to keep this play alive along the boards. Hukin takes the body. Janan rotates back, finds McLeod. McLeod makes a great pass to Vitali. That was the delayed penalty that was coming. And then McLaughlin comes all the way in from the point, and the presence of mind to get that leverage in order to go up.
That very impressive 6-1 win, and so far an impressive start tonight for both squads. 1-1 our score. Northeastern, though, with the man advantage now for a minute 25 to go here in the first period. Over to the left side, a shot there from Hukin, but his stick broke on the shot. Boston University able to clear, and Brandon Yip's got an opportunity. Yip going in short-handed. Save made. Tees into the rebound. Score! No one could find the puck, but Nick Bonino did, and he gets his third goal of this Beanpot.
Interesting comments between periods. Kobe Cohen for the BU Terriers, who scored the first goal when he ripped one short side high on the power play. How about Brandon Yip? He tries to beat Teason to the glove side high. That went up over the crossbar. Bonino comes late following the play up. And where does his shot go? High again, right up under the crossbar, this time on the blocker side. Much worse is his defense partner when there's a battle along the boards. And a one-man forecheck by Bonino in the offensive zone.
Quayler was able to skate through three Terriers there. Final 5 seconds of the power play for the Huskies coming to an end. So they are back to even strength now. 1-for-5 officially. Shot sails through. Score! McNeely all alone in front. And we're tied at 2.
Well, after a quality penalty kill by the BU Terriers, you get into that dangerous time when the team gets back to 5-on-5, and the problem is you had 3 BU Terriers kind of sniffing that puck in the corner of the rink. That opens up for that shot from the right point. The overhead will show where McNeely will go, right to the top of the crease. He's the one that actually gets the redirect. Milan doesn't really quick. It was just a wrist shot. He knew he had three BU players in the corner. He knew he had a chance for a two-on-one in front of the net. Release that puck, get it there. He had Quayler as well as McNeely rotating back to the front of the net.
Wilson keeping the puck alive on the far side. In front, score! Lawrence! And once again, Boston University reclaims a one-goal lead.
Well, they've been a dominant team all year long in even strength situations. And after they make a mistake to allow the Huskies to tie the hockey game, they play to their strength. They play 5-on-5. They get the cycle game going. The nice rotation by the Wilson-Higgins-Lawrence line. And Higgins is going to find Lawrence from one side.
Finds Janan. Down low, he plays it. They get it up top. Eukin with room. Shoots it into Yip, and it was blocked. Worsowski will carry out. Worsowski going in shorthanded. Scores! David Worsowski, the freshman out of Marshfield, makes it a two-goal lead.
Well, I don't know how often it is that you see two defensemen leading a 2-on-1 in the third period of a one-goal game in the Beanpot Final while you're shorthanded, but that's exactly what's going to happen. Worsowski with the puck, takes a look over his left shoulder, sees he has Greiber coming, but the passing lane isn't there, and he makes the right decision to take a shot on goal. A, you don't want to miss the net. B, you don't want to be too fine with that shot because you could be in trouble if you miss the goal. But he does the best thing possible for the BU Terrier fans. He beats tees and glove side for a two-goal lead for BU.
Prior to Friday night's game against UMass Lowell, David Worsowski played 26 games without a goal. Now he's got a two-game goal scoring streak, and none bigger than the one that gives his Terriers a little bit of insurance in the Beanpot Championship. But again, the defenseman leading the way. This time he gets it to Wilson. He scores! Shattenkirk finds Colin Wilson, and Wilson finds the back of the net.
Another two-on-one for BU. Northeastern sensing desperation time, down by two. Still on the power play. They take some chances in the offensive zone, and that's a green light for any penalty-killing team, especially with the skill level of BU. What a great two-on-one. The dish by Shattenkirk, head up the whole way. A good feel for where the passing lane is, underneath the stick of Strathman.
Period Lowell had on this past Friday night. So as a freshman, Milan backstops Boston University to the Beanpot Championship. For the 29th time, the Terriers are top dogs on the second Monday of February.